Hey.
Hey.
This is the exact spot.
What?
My first night I came back to Stuckeyville 3 years ago. This is where we were.
Right. Make any interesting decisions lately?
Yes, I have.
So, let me get this straight. Molly stole Carol's diary.
Yes.
And she read it to you.
Parts of it, yes.
What's Carol doing keep a diary? I mean, who is she, Jam Brady?
Nothing wrong with it. I keep a journal myself, as you well know. You should, too.
Ah, we're cutting into my TV watching time. Besides, I can't see myself writing Dear Diary.
I don't write Dear Diary.
Yeah, sure you don't. So tell me, why did Molly commit this act of grand larceny?
She thinks I'm in denial about Carol's feelings for me, and I gotta tell you, Mike, she's right. You know, it was a lot easier when I could pretend the feelings weren't real, but after hearing all the stuff she's written about me, I gotta face it. I got a decision to make.
It's like I've been saying all along.
This is, of course, provided that the Frankie option is still even available.
Oh, so you haven't heard from her, huh?
Nah, she's still in Houston with good old Leon.
Well, my friend, it sounds like you better figure out what the hell you're doing.
Yeah, I know.
Dear Diary, Carol or Frankie, whoever will it be, let me see.
Please stop talking.
What's this meeting about?
The Stuckeyville 75th birthday party.
Oh, why do we have to plan that? Why can't we just get Colin Cowie?
Who's Colin Cowie?
He's Hollywood's top event planner. He just did this massive bash for William Dafoe.
Willem.
What?
Willem.
I don't know what that means.
All right, look, Ed is counting on us. So we got to do this party real fast, and we only have a few days. Shirley, you in charge of the music? I need you to find me a good cover band.
I once saw a group in Jaspertown that played Beatles and Eagles songs. They were called the Beagles.
Oh, boo, keep on looking, all right? Hey, Stubbs, can you get us some fireworks?
Yeah, what kind do you want? Wheels, cones, sparkler spinners, Roman candles, phantom racers, ninja masters, dancing devils, typhoon blasters, midnight thrillers, gorilla killers, Phyllis Stillers, Barney Millers, Wojo.
All right, look, whatever your goofy ass wants, I'm in charge of food and invitations.
Hey, I got somebody for your list, Vivian Gonda.
Oh, come on, not that again.
No, you know you like her. Just ask her to be your date.
All right, just fall back before I slap the stupid out your head.
It's not even original. He got that from Cedric the Entertainer.
Oh, hey, Carol.
Ed, hi.
You headed to school?
Yeah, you headed to court?
Yeah. Yeah.
Alrighty then.
Yeah, how you doing anyway, Carol? Are you okay?
I'm fine.
You are?
Yeah.
You are? You're fine? That's good. I'm glad.
You're glad that I'm fine?
Yes. You deserve to be fine.
I do?
Yeah. I mean, you're a teacher, for the love of Pete. You know, I don't praise you nearly enough for the work you do every day, you know, for the kids, for the future of this country. Thank you. Thank you.
Why are you acting like this?
Like what?
Like a buffoon!
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Ed.
Molly read me your diary.
What?
No, just the parts about me.
Oh my God!
No, don't freak out. Don't freak out. Nothing embarrassing. Embarrassing. Strictly PG. Not even PG-13.
No,
just PG. Not even PG.
Oh,
just
no,
G.
No,
approved
no,
for general
no,
audiences.
Oh,
that's
oh,
all.
Oh.
She, Molly just wanted me to...
I can't. I cannot.
Nope.
How could you?
I'm going to have to call you back. You seem upset.
Oh, very good. You must be psychic. Now, what reason could I possibly have to be upset?
Okay, please sit down and let me try and explain this.
Oh, please. Explain.
I threw a Hail Mary.
What? What is that?
What about sitting?
What? I'm too upset to sit.
Carol, I saw Ed slipping away from you. There were like 2 seconds left in the game, and I felt like I had to resort to something drastic, so I sent everybody into the end zone, and I threw up a Hail Mary.
That is a completely unacceptable explanation.
What did he say?
Why do you have to renovate the attic?
We're adding a bedroom for George's mother.
Oh, she's moving in.
Yes, and I'm thrilled to have her, but I'm not looking forward to all of that construction.
You know, I should put you in touch with the contractor we use for our kitchen.
Oh, yeah?
Named Supko. I don't know if that's his first name or his last name. He's from one of those funny countries somewhere, but he's amazing.
Promise you'll email me his number?
I will. It's Z-U-P-K-O.
Why are these dinner parties always so lame?
Hey, humans are just boring.
It's better when we're all busy hunting and gathering. Back then, nobody had time to show their pictures of their trips to Legoland.
Hey, Mike, I think those motorists are in trouble.
Motorists?
Yeah, that was kind of weird, wasn't it?
You okay?
We got a flat and we have no jack.
Oh, we have a jack.
Really?
Great.
So, where are you guys from?
We're seniors at Glenmark College.
Oh, cool.
All set, ladies.
Wow, that was fast.
I was an intern at Jiffy Lube.
Well, thanks again.
Kidding, there's no internships at Jiffy Lube. That'd be ridiculous.
Hey, you girls get home safe.
Hey, there's a party tomorrow night at our dorm. If you guys want to come, we'd love to give you a thank you beer.
Thanks, that's sweet, but we're old.
Speak for yourself. I'm kidding, I'm old too.
If you change your mind, we're in Hill Hall.
Good night.
That bomb was hot.
And there goes any chance you had of having sex with me tonight.
Frankie, you're back.
Yes.
Good. How's Houston?
It was fun.
Good. Warm there now?
Spring-like temperatures.
Well, that's dandy. Not a person alive doesn't like spring-like temperatures. And Leon? You saw Leon?
Yep, saw him.
Good. How was that?
You know, fine.
Well, great. Spring-like temperatures, Leon? Sounds like you had yourself a home run weekend.
Excuse me, I'm gonna get a cup of coffee.
My life's going great. Let's have a picnic.
What?
Let's have a picnic. Grab a cup of sandwich, go to the park for no reason.
I have to finish this brief.
No. Why eat indoors when we can eat outdoors? Come on, what do you say?
Thank you, I'm fine here.
I really think we need to have a picnic.
What's wrong with you?
Wrong with me? Nothing. Nothing's wrong with me. Nothing's wrong with me. I just think, frankly, I'm making a perfectly good argument for having a picnic when the burden of proof lies squarely on the shoulders of the person who doesn't want to have a picnic.
What does that even mean?
Let's have a picnic. Didn't I tell you this would be great?
Kind of windy.
It's not that windy. It's kind of a delightful breeze, really.
It's too cold to have a picnic.
Oh, it's not too cold to have a picnic. The Eskimos have picnics in temperatures much colder than this.
I'm not sure about that.
Well, they do. Here, have some German potato salad.
Thank you for coming. It's always an honor to meet a man of your profession. To me, fireworks are more than just pretty lights. They're closest we ever come to touching the face of the Lord himself.
What do you need, sir?
Just to give you some idea.
You understand, sir, that's one of the biggest displays of all time. The Grucci's did that for $1.7 million.
What, are you trying to handle me now?
Am I what, sir?
2 minutes in, he's trying to handle me. What can you do for 50 bucks?
For 50 bucks? I can go like this.
Phil, we have more than 50.
Eli,
would you let me bargain with them, man?
Will you meet me at 51?
Good luck, fellas.
us.
Wait, excuse, wait, sir.
Oh, no, no, no. Let him go. Let him go. He doesn't deserve us. Hey, Eli, check it out. Miss Vivian is in the house. Time to make your move.
You know, you are the world's most annoying dude.
Come on, man. I just saved us $1.7 million.
I have a few carefully chosen things I'd like to say, and I'd appreciate it if I could say them without interruption.
Okay.
For the last few days, I have been throwing myself at you, and this has taken many different forms, not the least of which being me telling you that I am, in fact, throwing myself at you. This has made me feel a whole new emotion I've never experienced before that I like to label jackassiness.
Carol, you don't have to explain.
I'm not done yet.
Right? Sorry.
The cherry on top of the humiliation Sunday, of course, would be my best friend stealing my private journals and reading my most intimate thoughts to you, which...
Carol, why did... Right.
Which leads me to one simple question.
Which is?
Molly said she thought you had a decision to make. Can you tell me you're 100% certain you do not want to be with me? Because if you can, say it now and I will walk right out that door.
It's complicated.
I'll take that. I'm walking out the door, but it's a different kind of walk. It's not the what I said. It's a... This is the jackassiness feeling I'm having again.
Well, here we are, Hill Hall.
It's really weird.
Come on, it'll be fun. Oh, relax, honey. This is going to be great. See this? This is a real party. These people aren't just pretending to have fun. These people are having actual fun.
Yeah, I don't know if I remember how to have actual fun.
Well, that's why we're here.
Oh, my God!
Hey!
This is awesome!
Come on, we'll introduce you to everybody.
Our first introduce is the keg.
Right?
Let's get this party started. Woo!
Cannot.
I'm telling you, I totally can.
There's no way. I don't believe.
Oh, I'm telling you, I can do it.
Can he really? Oh, yeah, yeah. I gotta hope he doesn't.
Yeah.
Come on, let's see.
Uh-huh. All right.
Yes, yeah, please.
All right, folks, clear it out.
Go, Mike! Go, Mike!
Go, Mike! Go, Mike! It's your birthday! It's your birthday! Go, Mike! Go, Mike!
It's not my birthday!
It's just what people say!
Go, Mike! Go, Mike! It's your birthday! It's your birthday! Go, Mike! Go, Mike! Give me time!
Come on, you big goofball! Let's dance!
Come on, dance! You know that?
You just did!
That's breaking. That's different.
Fine.
Let's go, Terry.
You guys are hilarious. I wish you went to school here.
Oh, you know, I just might sign up for a course or two. It's never too late to learn Japanese. That's my wife.
Ed,
Frankie.
I need to talk to you.
About what?
In private.
Okay,
let's go behind the lanes.
Why don't we just go
to the
office?
I'm going to be gesticulating a great deal and people will see me through the window.
What are you going to be gesticulating?
Can we wait until we get behind the lanes?
Okay.
I don't want to do this anymore.
What? You don't want to do what?
Pout for effect.
What?
Yes, yes, I've been pouting in order to make a point, and this strategy does not fit well for someone with my personality.
What point?
Do you know what a golden doodle is?
Golden doodle? No?
It's a new kind of dog. It's a cross between a golden retriever and a poodle.
All right.
A golden retriever is always going to be a golden retriever, and a poodle is always going to be a poodle. And either way, you're never going to be a golden doodle, no matter how hard you try.
This is the point you're trying to make?
No, the point I'm trying to make is that if you want a golden doodle, go find a golden doodle, because I am never going to be a golden doodle.
I don't even know what a golden doodle is.
Leon called me. He wants me to fly back to Houston and give things another try.
And?
And I really want to be here with you. But not if you want me to be a golden doodle, because as I previously stated, I'm never going to be that.
I'm having trouble understanding the golden doodle thing.
I'm not going to compete with Carol Vesey.
Frankie, I don't want you to compete with...
And I'm on a plane tomorrow night to Houston, unless you give me a reason to stay.
How do I do that?
Make up your mind. Once and for all.
Who's here? It's Mommy. Top of the morning to you, Mommy.
Oh, Louie boys, Mommy will annihilate you.
Oh, you're gonna feel fine. Here, drink this. Hair of the dog.
Ugh, take that away. Take it away.
All right, I'm off to work. Honey, Stacy invited us into one of those parties tonight. Assume you're in?
You got to be kidding.
Why, we had a great time.
Oh, Mike, don't be ridiculous. Once is enough. There is no way I'm going back there.
But it's luau night.
Besides, Sarah and I are going over to my parents tonight.
Oh, right. Right. All right, well, I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Easy. Mm-hmm. Up here.
Carol. Hey.
Good morning.
You're in a tree.
Yes, I am.
Why in a tree?
Because for the last couple days you've had me out on a limb.
Out on a limb?
Yeah, and it's no fun being out on a limb, and I'm not particularly good at it.
Yeah,
so I...
actually, out on a limb, you realize that, right? I mean, you're like in a nook.
I got scared. The point is, I don't know how much longer I can stay out on the limb. I need you to let me down.
Literally?
No, I need you to decide what your deal is, and soon.
I know. I understand. You made your point.
Good. So let me down.
I will, Carol. I promise. I mean, I just need to sort a few things out. And,
Ed,
you know, yeah.
Literally, let me down. Thank you.
Welcome.
Mike?
Stacy, hey, what are you doing?
Just stopped by to say hi. Found you in the phone book.
Oh, well, cool. Hi.
So this is your office, huh?
Yeah, this is where all the magic happens. If you want to call throat cultures magic. The splinter removals, we got a lot of splinters in here.
Dr. Burton?
So did you have fun last night?
Yeah, I had a blast.
Want to repay me?
How?
Jenny and I have this brutal chemistry exam. Come help us study.
Me?
You're a doctor, you know chemistry, right?
Excuse me, Dr. Burton. I do hate to interrupt, but I need you in the exam room. Could you please take your thumb out of your ass and join me? Thank you. Good day, miss.
Guess I better let you go.
Yeah. Leave me your number.
Stubbs, I saw.
Well, you gonna ask her out, or am I gonna have to make you?
How you gonna make me?
It's easy. I'll put you on a rope and some pulleys like the dead guy at Weekend at Bernie's.
Oh, you really wanna beat down, don't you?
Fine, forget it. I'll ask her myself.
What?
I'm just saying it's a shame to let such a fine specimen of female pulchritude go to waste.
Obedience. Sit your ass down.
That's my Eli.
Hey, Vivian. How you doing?
Good, Eli. How about you?
I'm doing good. Hey, listen, I just wanted to know, would you like to come with me to the Stucky Bowl party?
Oh, I'm sorry, Eli. I can't.
Nah?
But thank you.
Ah, that's all good. It's probably gonna be worth nothing anyway. All right, I'll let you.
All right, very good, very good. You guys are on fire. All right, Jenny, Avogadro's number, give it to me.
Avogadro's number, 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd.
That's right, and it's the number of what, Stacy?
Particles in the mole.
That's correct.
Yes.
All right, my work's done here. You guys are totally gonna ace this thing.
Hey, Mike, are you forgetting something?
What's that?
Luau night.
Luau night?
I don't know. Yeah, you're coming.
I don't know. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the secret to a perfectly roasted pig is constant rotation. Constant rotation. Tiny bubbles in the wine makes me feel happy, makes me feel fine.
What the hell is that?
Are you kidding? That's legendary Don Ho, Mr. Waikiki himself. What's the matter with you?
Let's hear some more.
Oh, that's all I know.
What?
Yeah, it's, I learned it from one of those K-Tel record commercials. I only ever heard like 8 seconds of the song.
Then how can you bust on me for not knowing it?
You're right. I apologize for misrepresenting the depth of my Don Ho knowledge base.
I forgive you. Thanks for walking me home.
Sure, no problem. Thanks for the party.
So, I think you should come up and hang out.
Oh, man.
Come on.
I can't.
I think you can.
I think I should go while it's still humanly possible.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Okay. Good night.
Good night.
Gentlemen, thank you for your interest in performing at the Stucky Bowl 75th birthday party. Please state the name of your combo.
The Warren Cheswick Experience.
A few brief background questions. Would you each please identify your favorite Beatle?
John.
Paul.
George.
George.
And your all-time favorite recording artist?
Led Zeppelin.
Crosby, Stills, and Nash.
Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young.
Phil Collins, except no substitutes.
If hired for the party, you will be expected to play requests on short notice. Please now perform Everybody Plays the Fool by The Main Ingredient.
Everybody plays. What do they play? The fool. Everybody plays the fool. But if you are in school, you better be a fool.
And so on. This is first verse.
You're hired, gentlemen.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, buddy.
What's going on? What you doing?
Not a whole heck of a lot. Just trying to make the toughest decision of my life is all.
Wonton or hot and sour? Most of my tough decisions involve Chinese food. But there's always occasional exception, like tonight.
Tonight? What was tonight?
Well,
Mike?
I almost cheated on Nancy.
What?
Yeah, you remember those college girls?
Yeah, from the party?
Yeah, there's this one girl, Stacy.
Oh, man. Please tell me nothing happened.
No, nothing happened, but there's a part of me that really wanted it to.
You serious?
Yeah, I'm serious. I love my wife. I love my daughter. I love being a husband and a father. It's great. But there's something about being a 19-year-old doofus with nothing to worry about except remembering the name of my fake ID is Benjamin Horowitz. You know? I miss it sometimes, that's all.
The chat room guy.
Eric Saperstein 2307, I presume?
Yeah. So you're looking for fireworks?
You got the candy?
I got the spizzle.
What?
If you have fireworks and I'd like to buy them with money.
Well then, let's do some business.
I don't know if what you got's any good.
Dude, these fireworks are imported from Brazil. They make American fireworks look like they belong at the kids' table.
Well, as I said to the guy who sold me my George Foreman grill, you got me.
Oh, yeah. Hit me.
Oh! You know what it is, Mike? She made you feel like a kid again.
Oh, come on, please. Please don't reduce my life to a cliche.
I'm telling you, man, there's no romance like teenage romance. There's no love quite like the simple, dumb, blinding love of a teenage crush.
We just changed the subject?
Yeah. Sorry.
It's okay. So what's on your mind? What are you thinking?
Well, this whole Stacy thing, it actually reminds me of Carol.
What?
Well, think back to how young I was when I fell in love with Carol. I was 15 years old. I hadn't even spoken to her yet.
So?
So, 3 years from now, Carol's been telling me that she can't be with me because I put her on a pedestal like she's some kind of idealized dream girl. Well, what if she's right? What if she's been right all along?
How do you like the sandwich?
Good.
Any comments? Questions?
Nope.
Aha! That turkey is a buck a pound cheaper than our regular turkey, and since you can't tell the difference, we've not only got ourselves some delicious new turkey, but also some delicious new savings.
I went to luau night.
What?
I went to luau night.
At the college?
Yeah. It was when you and Sarah went to your parents. Stacy came to my office and asked me to help her and her friend study. So I did, you know, and next thing I knew, we were at luau night.
Okay, Michael, I'm gonna ask you to sit back down. Anything you'd like to tell me about luau night?
There's a big pig.
Mike?
Nothing happened, okay? Nothing happened, but almost did.
Well, I'm seriously in need of a definition of almost.
End of the night, I walked Stacy back to her dorm. She kind of moved in for a kiss. But I didn't do it.
You didn't?
No.
Why not?
Because it wouldn't have been worth it.
You're crazy. Girl was a babe and a half.
Believe me, I know. But she was nothing compared to my wife, who's a babe in 3/4.
It's good safe, honey.
Eli, where'd you get those hats?
Oh, come on.
You gotta start talking to me sometime. We love each other. We do. We love each other.
You know, you don't listen, man. I told you I wasn't ready to talk to no girl, but you kept on yapping away. Yip, 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 yip. Like one of them little foo-foo dogs with a $40 head, dude, that'll grab your leg and won't let go.
Is that black slang? Because I'm not following you.
Dude, a woman as fine as Vivian Gondar will not talk to a guy in a wheelchair.
Well, how do you know it's the wheelchair? Maybe she just doesn't like you.
What?
Think about it. You don't have a great personality. I don't think you're a particularly attractive man.
Wait. Hold up. Fall back. Before this happened to me, there wasn't a woman alive that could resist the rap of Eli Cartwright Goggins III.
Yeah. I keep hearing about the rap. And what was your big line here? Would you like to go to the Stucky Bowl party with me? It's very creative.
You're missing the point, man. Not even William Shakespeare could smooth talk a woman in one of these things, man.
No, you missing the point. Girls reject dudes. That's what they do. And why does a girl reject a dude? Maybe she don't like the sound of his voice. Maybe she don't like his threads. And yes, maybe she don't like his wheelchair. But we dudes. So we pick ourselves up and we go back for more. What?
You talking like me, Nick?
Might have been.
Hey, what's going on?
I made a decision.
Yeah?
Frankie.
Really?
Yep.
How'd Carol take the news?
I haven't told her yet.
You think you better get that over with?
Yeah, I better get that over with.
Let's go ahead.
Hey, Ed.
Yeah?
If you don't come back alive, can I have this?
Yeah. Hey, Molly, have you seen Carol?
No, she took the day off. What's going on?
No, nothing. I just have to tell her something. See ya.
See ya.
I don't think I can take you being adorable right now.
I'm sorry. I can't turn that off.
If I sleep too much, a good Chinese apple chant to the touch. My sleep feeling capital. It's hard to change something supernatural.
She could use a shot of Botox between lanes 9 and 10. Thank you, Jimmy. All right, the request lines are open. You say it, we play it.
Tears of a Clown.
You got it, Godfrey. Tears of a Clown from Motown to Yotown. Hit it, boys.
Yeah, I don't know. Just do something.
And he cried. He had tears streaming down his face.
children laugh. You have to make them cry. You sick, sick clown. You demented clown. I hate you, clown. Yeah.
Ed's missing his own party.
He's a lucky man. Come on, honey, let's dance.
I thought you didn't dance.
I don't. Come on.
Shouting their magic words and drinking their elixir.
Now you?
A ship in harbor is safe, but that's not what ships are for. I spent 3 hours searching for the perfect quotation to inspire you. It was either that one or the following gem from Groucho Marx. Outside of a dog, a book is man's best friend. Inside of a dog, it's too dark to read.
Shirley, what does that have to do with anything?
Nothing, that's why I didn't choose it. Now go.
If she likes him, I get the credit. You know that, right? I mean, you just can't swoop in here at the last minute and expect to get the credit.
I don't care about credit. I just want Eli to be happy.
Credit.
Goodbye.
What?
You haven't given me a reason to stay.
Frankie.
Hey.
Hey.
Ed's here.
Oh, boy.
What do you think he's doing?
He got me.
You know, don't you?
I must never betray the confidence of his best friend.
Hello? Carol, where are you? Yeah, we're all here at... Yeah, he's here. He's talking to Frankie.
Wait, Carol, hold on a sec.
Is that Carol?
Yeah.
Carol, it's me. Listen, we need to talk. Stay put, I'm coming to you.
This is the exact spot.
What?
My first night I came back to Stockyville 3 years ago. This is where we were.
You're right. Make any interesting decisions lately?
Yes, I have.
You're not going to make me guess, are you?
First time I ever laid eyes on you was ninth grade. Mr. Rourke's biology class. I looked across the room, and you were pouring water into a test tube. You were wearing a blue shirt.
with white crisscross strings right down the sides. And the moment I saw you, I just went. Carol, from the day I came back here to Stuckeyville and I walked into your classroom to ask you out, and all the other times I asked you out since, you just kept telling me the same thing over and over and over again. I didn't fall in love with you, but rather some high school kid's fixated version of you. When I thought about it, I thought about it, and I decided, you're right. I didn't fall in love with you. I fell in love with that girl wearing the blue shirt with the white crisscross strings down the side that I never said a single word to in high school. So I decided to be with Frankie. So I went to look for you. I went to look for you to tell you. I looked all over. I looked at the smiling goat. I looked at your high school. I looked at your house. I looked all over. And a funny thing happened. Everywhere I went, I saw us. Laughing, crying, arguing. And I realized, yeah, maybe I fell in love with that girl wearing the blue shirt with the white crisscross strings down the sides in high school, but now, I love you. I love you. I love every part of you. And we have to be together.
Could I please kiss you now?